Fun project, one of the best, I think most enjoyable projects we've worked on in a long, long time, and from several perspectives. To do this vehicle, sort of, the answer that we've got here wasn't entirely clear to us up front. It's way clearer to us now what it should be. But originally, we were, when we started the project, small, wide Jeep, where do we go with it? And we usually cultivate two sides of Jeep, the Wrangler side of the family or the Grand Cherokee side of the family. And we honestly explored both of those outlets when we first started looking at this in small clays and sketches. As we got progressing with it, and to be clear, the vehicle was designed and engineered 100% in Auburn Hills in Michigan. It was not just dropped off in Italy. The answer that we have here, I mean, it was just really clear to us the more and more we got digging at it. And at the end of the day, we just want to get as much Wrangler character and fun, that side of the Jeep, into this small package. And as we got going with it, these answers came up over and over again, and it just made complete sense to us. But again, at the beginning, when we were staring at a blank sheet of paper, that really wasn't the case at all. What I mean by the Wrangler influence of this vehicle is all the line work on it really is stood up. It's not a fast windshield, it's what we call a slow windshield, very vertical like a Wrangler. The front end being very wall-like, vertical front end to it, helped to short, it's already a small vehicle, but all those lines, instead of trying to get them to relax, they're very, very vertical. The chair position in it, you sit up sort of high, and the windows are unwound a little bit, flat roof. Heretic that we are, we actually lowered the belt line to get larger windows, and that's, again, from Wrangler getting a bigger window on the side. Of course, the front end, big round headlights, 7-slot grille, we've got to have that, but it's cool that comes from day one of Jeep in 1941. I love that we cultivate those kind of design cues. The trapezoidal wheel arch, if you don't know, that really comes from the very first Wrangler, or it wasn't a Wrangler, but the Army Jeep, 1941. This vehicle is full of exaggerated expression to it. Everything's a little bit bigger. The wheel flares are actually quite a bit larger than you would think. The lights are bigger, the mirrors are bigger. And it's, I relate it actually to a puppy dog. If you think about a Labrador puppy, everything's just sort of too big on it. And that's what's so cool about it. We try to walk it right up to the edge of cute. They don't want to go cute, but really tough in this small package. I've got three examples up here. This is a Limited. The Limited is noted by the bright grille, bright mirrors, bright roof racks. There's some tail lamp trim on it as well. 18-inch wheel. Trailhawk, this is our second Trailhawk model now. Very unique and different styling-wise from the other vehicles. No grip, no chrome on this. The fascias are actually different for a more aggressive approach angle and departure angle on the back. The vehicle physically sits a little higher, has its own unique tire wheel combination. It's a taller tire on it as well. The tow hooks, we love our tow hooks, and so much, even on a B-segment vehicle like this, to have a real forged tow hook that's 2.5 times the GVW. And then there's a third one on the back. Also, the roof is an option. You can get the roof painted out this black. That's really a trick to get these vertical lines, it's like the folding windshield of the Wrangler, get that apparent piece to it, and then the roll hoop on the back. Third model up here is the Latitude. And again, more Wrangler-like cues to it. Instead of the lamp being just integrated into the body, it's this separate piece that's sort of disassociated with the sheet metal and poked in there. What I'm holding in my hand, this is, we call it church gear, I don't think it has a real name. But there's a pretty unique thing about the Renegade. The roof is, there's an optional roof panel. This one they're removed from. They're two large plastic roof panels. They're opaque. They can be removed completely, or the front one can be slid back. This one has the electric roof. So the front panel can either move forward or back, or you can remove both of them. They fit in what I call the pizza bag, and it fits under the cargo area in the back. Pretty unique feature for it. But again, it's that inside-outside Wrangler GQ for it. There's a detail that is apparent throughout the vehicle, and if you've already heard about this, it's this X shape, and it's the designers picked this up. It's a stamping from the military fuel can that was used in World War II. There was a reinforcing X stamped into the tank. That X shows up in the headlights. It's very prominent on these roof panels. It's this big X across there, the taillights, and you'll see it again on the interior in some of the pieces. Explore the car. Ask me questions if we need to throughout the day. But I'm going to turn it over to Klaus Busse, and he's going to take you through the interior story of Renegade. Thank you, Klaus.
Thank you.